On the 20th of September 2007, in the town of Santa Cruz, Bolivia, God spoke to Brother Zach and commanded him to call the people of Christian Missionary Fellowship International to a season of evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. Committed to have his promises fulfilled to the fullest, God continued speaking to Brother Zach in different places and at different times, calling him to move all in Christian Missionary Fellowship International to obey the Santa Cruz message. These prophecies, which were received in Copenhagen, Nairobi, Paris, and London between November 2007 and May 2008, are still valid for all in Christian Missionary Fellowship International today. God is still calling each one in Christian Missionary Fellowship International to urgently arise and obey the Santa Cruz message. My son, the Santa Cruz prophecy is my word to all in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. It is my word and I am watching over it to fulfill it to the fullest. Oh, that my children would believe me and obey me, so that I do all that I have promised to do in them and through them. Thousands of my children in Christian Missionary Fellowship International have not read the prophecy in its entirety, and thousands have not had it read to them, and consequently, they are going about thinking, talking, and acting as if I had not spoken. This is my way for bringing revival to Christian Missionary Fellowship International. Those who refuse to believe me, and consequently fail to cooperate with me, would have missed the hour of my visitation, and I would hold them accountable for it. Have you heard me? I am saying that I would hold those who fail to cooperate with me accountable for the loss that they will cause me to incur in their lives, and for the losses that they will cause me to incur in the lives of those they have blocked by their failure to cooperate fully with me. What I have asked my children to do is simple and clear, and it should be done. Those who have obeyed are already enjoying my visitation, and more is coming for them. Because I must have revival in Christian Missionary Fellowship International as a prelude to the heaven-rending, earth-shaking, and Christ-glorifying global revival of my entire body, I give Christian Missionary Fellowship International an extended period for their cooperation with me in this matter. The period of investing everything into evangelism, soul winning, and church planting is extended to the 27th of January 2008. I will hold you responsible for any national leader or international missionary who does not have the prophecy and this extension. I will hold every national leader and every international missionary responsible for every shepherd under his leadership who does not have the prophecy and this extension. I will hold every shepherd responsible for each person he or she shepherds who has not read the prophecy or had it read to him or her. To steer worldwide action, let those national leaders, international missionaries, senior local church pastors, national missionaries, local church pastors, house church pastors, etc., who are having breakthroughs, send information about their exploits to headquarters so that it may be known across the entire work. The Lord's special message to me. A window is open in heaven for special blessings to flow on those who take the Santa Cruz prophecy as a divine imperative. A window is open in heaven. I am on the move to bless. Let all hurry. My son, A window is open in heaven for special blessings to flow on those who take the Santa Cruz prophecy as a divine imperative and on their efforts in evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. Because all in heaven is open to bless evangelism, soul winning, and church planting, those who want to benefit from what is being released from heaven should give themselves exclusively to this one task. This is not the time to correct errors. This is not the time to lay new foundations. This is not the time to train leaders. This is not the time to seek God, in quotes. This is not the time to hold special meetings to edify the believers. This is time to invest all in evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. This is not the time to talk, speculate, and discuss evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. This is the time to actually carry out evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. I command everyone in Christian Missionary Fellowship International to obey the Santa Cruz prophecy, to keep mobilizing people to obey it, and to work at it relentlessly. On the 27th of January 2008, all shall send their numbers as of that day to the headquarters, and then the year of evangelism, soul winning, and church planting shall take off and continue until the end of the year 2008. The Santa Cruz prophecy is further extended until 31st of December 2008. The year 2008 is the year of evangelism, soul winning, and church planting, with heaven open in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. I declare the year of 2008 a season of evangelism, soul winning, and church planting in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. The season shall go on and on and on with short breaks of a few days, instead of what happened in the past when seasons of evangelism came on from time to time. As I said before, this is my way of revival in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. One thing that is going to happen is that those who give themselves wholeheartedly to evangelism, soul winning, and church planting will begin to know conviction of sin, hatred of sin, confession of sin, forsaking of sin, sanctification, and being filled with the Holy Spirit at evangelistic meetings and during their evangelistic outreaches. The Holy Spirit will come upon some while they are still being baptized. The Holy Spirit will come upon some as they are preparing to go out and evangelize. The Holy Spirit will come upon some as they gather to give thanks for those who have just been won to Christ. The Holy Spirit will come down in power on individuals, on pairs, on threes, on fours, on tens, on entire house churches, on large crowds, and so forth. There will be signs, wonders, and miracles in all directions. I will do wonders among the children. I will do wonders among the youths. And I will do wonders among the adults. I will visit all the classes. I will bless on. And as my spirit and power come upon people, they must turn or be turned to evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. I will sanctify, but people shall be caught up, not with sanctification, but with evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. I will revive, but people shall be caught up, not with revival, but with evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. I will cause signs, wonders, and miracles to be released, but people shall not be caught up with signs, wonders, and miracles, but rather with evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. I command all in Christian Missionary Fellowship International to invest their all in this one direction, and by the end of December 2008, there will be massive numbers of believers in the work. And all the believers will not only love me wholeheartedly, but they will be red hot with the Holy Spirit and with fire. The only accountability that is compulsory for all international and national missionaries for the year 2008 is accomplishments in evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. They could include other issues if they like, but accounts must be written and submitted on the time individually invested into evangelism, soul winning, and church planting, as well as the overall increase in numbers in their work month by month. A window is open in heaven to give everyone in Christian Missionary Fellowship International his or her time of divine visitation and divine visitation of the entire movement. Fast and pray that neither the entire movement nor any individual in it miss the grace of God through unbelief, a cold heart towards God, laziness, indulgence, worldly cares, fear of failure, or distractions. A window is open in heaven. I am on the move to bless. Let all hurry. The Lord's special message to me. Church is of great, very great, very great numbers, a must in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. My son, churches that are 10,000s, 20,000s, 30,000s, 40,000s, 50,000s, 100,000s, 200,000s, 500,000s, etc., cannot come out of faithful and good work. Such churches are birthed and led by people who do great deeds on one hand and do ordinary things extraordinarily on the other hand. For leaders of a local church to expect massive growth in numbers while investing in the ordinary, in prayer alone, prayer with others, daily dynamic encounters with God, Bible reading, reading Christian literature, retreats for spiritual progress, fasting, giving to God, soul winning, and the making of disciples is self-deception. These routines must be pursued with a harsh and continuous aggressiveness on one hand, while great deeds in some of these disciplines are being carried out in order to break and keep new grounds. I will give churches with very large numbers to aggressive, fierce, and restless leaders who live to win souls at all cost and whose entire lives say to me, give me the largest numbers in the shortest possible time or take my life. Such cries are heard and answered by heaven. Those whose lives lack such aggressiveness, fierceness, and restlessness must be satisfied with small numbers or attain large numbers after centuries. I want churches of great, very, very great numbers in Christian Missionary Fellowship International. This is what heaven wants. Move your people to produce them. They are able.
It can be done, it must be done.
The Lord's special message to me. A word of warning to all national and international missionaries. The national and international missionary is sent out to win the lost to the Lord Jesus in the largest numbers in the shortest time. He or she is sent to bar the gates of hell to the people for whom the Lord Jesus Christ died to save. He or she is sent to open the gates of heaven to the people for whom the blood of the Lord was poured forth. The national and international missionary is to walk at the rescue of the lost morning, afternoon, evening, and night, and bear much abiding fruit in ever-increasing numbers in ever-increasing localities. For this work, I have made a sevenfold provision in the finished work of the Lord Jesus, which are the life of radical new birth, the life of absolute surrender, the life of sanctification, that is, freedom from sin, freedom from the love of the world, freedom from the love of the things in the world, freedom from the life of self and the love of self, and freedom from the love of celebrity, the life clothed with power from on high, the life of prayer, the life of fasting, and the life of extreme hard work in the rescue of those who must perish if they are not immediately rescued. The missionary needs to live in the power generated from the sevenfold experience and life stated above, and there will be unceasing fruitfulness in his or her life. Anyone deficient in any of the above has chosen to be deficient, for I have given my all to those I have sent out to labor for me. His divine power has given us everything we need for life and godliness through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3. For the winning of abiding souls in the greatest numbers in the shortest time, the single non-negotiable requirement is the clothing with power from on high. The endowment with power from on high will enable a missionary to win and keep more souls in 1 week than he or she has won on his own in 5 years. It is forbidden to continue to do anything for the perishing without the anointing. It is attempting to do with the flesh what only the power of the Holy Spirit can do. I forbade the apostles and the 72 to do soul work without this anointing. And this can be seen in the following Bible passages: Matthew chapter 16 verse 17 to 20, Luke chapter 24 verse 45 to 49, and Acts chapter 1 verse 4 to 8. They were specially selected by the Lamb. They were specially trained by him. They were absolutely surrendered, as can be seen in the passages Mark chapter 1 verse 14 to 20 and Mark chapter 10 verse 28. They were sanctified to some measure, as can be seen in the book of John chapter 13 verse 10. They had the power to heal and cast out demons, as can be seen in Luke chapter 9 verse 1 to 2 and Luke chapter 10 verse 17 to 19. However, they needed the power from on high to win the lost who would abide in the largest numbers in the shortest time. When the power came upon them, in 1 day, the very day on which the power came upon them, 3,000 were saved, and all of the 3,000 abided. And on and on and on it continued until there were over 5,000 men, excluding women and children, in a very short time. The disciples and others invested 10 days in preparing their hearts and praying down the Holy Spirit. When their hearts were ready to be filled and to be used on the terms and conditions of the Holy Spirit, he came down upon each one, and it was a new day, and they were a new people. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and they all witnessed in the power of the Holy Spirit and produced fruit that abided in the power of the Holy Spirit. Every missionary who wants to bear abundant abiding fruit must be filled with the power from on high and continue to be filled with the power from on high increasingly and unceasingly. Such a missionary will then be used to win the lost in the tens, hundreds, and thousands in a short time, and the souls won will all abide. The disciples took 10 days to prepare. Let each missionary who sincerely and desperately wants to be filled with the Holy Spirit at all costs withdraw for 10 days and remove all the idols from his or her heart. When the last idol leaves the heart, I will immediately fill the missionary, and he or she will know without the slightest doubt that the Holy Spirit has come upon him or her. When the Holy Spirit has thus come upon him or her, the missionary should then set out to witness in the power of the Holy Spirit, and there will be a great and increasing harvest following his morning, afternoon, evening, and night labors at evangelism, soul winning, and church planting. along with signs, wonders, miracles, and persecution. Should the missionary stay absolutely surrendered, walking in all holiness and obedience, praying, fasting and seeking the Lord, and investing himself or herself ever increasingly in evangelism, soul winning, and church planting, the anointing will abide and increase, and the fruit will increase and abide. The anointing on the missionary will decrease and eventually cease if one or more idols are allowed to return to the heart and allowed to stay. The Holy Spirit and His power to win abiding souls to the Lord Jesus is given in fullness to those who obey Him fully in all that they know and in all that He commands them. When full obedience is abandoned, the fullness of the Holy Spirit and the fullness of power is also abandoned and lost. When a person allows this to happen, he may still go about carrying out evangelism, soul winning, and church planting, but there will be a reduction, a great reduction, or a total absence of genuine converts who abide. The person is now going about functioning as Shaven Samson, who did not know that the Holy Spirit had left him. Judges chapter 16, verse 1 to 20. All national and international missionaries who are not winning and keeping the largest numbers of souls in the shortest possible time are barren or of low productivity by personal choice. They have chosen to be unfruitful through laziness and powerlessness. They have actually resigned from being missionaries. They should send in their resignations so that others be sent to replace them. If they thus resign and get out of the way and so open up the field for other missionaries to replace them, I will not have to judge and remove them by drastic actions. I want much fruit that abides, as I commanded in the book of John chapter 15, verse 1 to 8, and I must have it. Those whom my most highly exalted Son died to save are going to hell because of lazy and powerless missionaries. I have endured this situation for long, and now I have risen against it and must act in judgment against those who cooperate with Satan to let those who could be saved if they heard the glorious gospel go to hell because they did not hear it.
On the hearts of the brethren. We pray, O God, that the Holy Spirit will speak to hearts at the depth of the hearts of God, that they may live whole.